Yeah, what's going on, everybody? It's iPod King Carter here, the Superman of YouTube. I'm here dropping the second screenshot and my thoughts on Ronnie 2K's My Player inside of NBA 2K13 MyCAREER mode. Now, before I jump into what I want to talk to, there's a lot of confusion going around. There's not too many players that understand what MyCAREER is. Basically, it's My Player mode revamped. If you're, you know, used to NBA 2K10, NBA 2K11, and NBA 2K12 My Player mode, this is still the same mode. It just has been renamed. It has been revamped. It has a lot of additions. And of course, you know what I'm about to talk about right now. But for all the people in the comment section that saying, hey, what is my career mode? Is it anything like my player mode? Yes, it is the same exact mode. It's just been revamped. Now, this screenshot is of a GM sit down. If you don't know what a GM sit down is, this is when your player, your star, your guy goes into the GM's office, sits in his nice chair, and look at the outfit that Ronnie 2K has on. He has on a pair of jeans and a t-shirt. I wonder, will you be able to put on any type of outfit when you go see your GM? Also, look at the GM. He has on all black. I don't know. I don't see no tie. I don't see anything. Look at his office. Look at how it's night outside. Look at the lamp. Look at the background. Look at the poster in the back. Look at the TV on the side. It's a lot of little bit of details that you got to look at in here. Now, we all remember from NBA 2K12 when you had to meet with somebody that came from the team during draft night. And, you know, you talked to them and got your thoughts on, you know, where you want to do, what you want to do with your career and stuff like that. That's basically the same thing as this, but this is ongoing throughout your career, which means your My Player inside of career mode can meet with the GM and give your suggestions on a roster. You can discuss your minutes. You could demand, request, or rescind a trade or more. They have so many different things that they probably have built up into this that, you know, they don't want to put out too much because the game isn't out. They want you to learn some things on your own when you get the game so you can still be awed and oohed and odd. But let me talk about the first thing, the suggestions on a roster. Now, in NBA 2K12, we didn't get that option. I don't remember being able to pick five players from another team. Realistic trades, you know, maybe a power forward for a power forward, a center for a center, a shooting guard for a shooting guard. I don't remember having that type of pull in NBA 2K12. Now, NBA 2K11, on the other hand, I remember that. I remember picking five guys. Sometimes, you know, it wouldn't even go that way. They might go after somebody else and stuff like that. Hopefully this year in this game, when you make suggestions, hopefully they listen to what you got to say and they actually do what you ask. Also, discussing minutes. Now, we all know in NBA 2K10, 11, and 12, when it came to your minutes, you used to just average a certain amount of minutes with the more playing time and the better you did. This year, just imagine if you're averaging 20 and 5 for like 4 weeks into the season. And you're saying, hey, I'm still averaging 13 minutes. I'm not getting enough. Usually in my player, it would have been better. But maybe you have to actually go to the GM and say, hey, can I get some more minutes, man? I'm putting my behind on the line. I know I can do more for the team. If you give me more minutes, I can show my worth. Hopefully, in this game, it does have that option. Now, let me discuss demanding, requesting, or rescinding a trade request. Now, with that being said, maybe there's some type of level of intensity that your player may have, the type of, you know, loyalty, his cockiness, and, you know, his professionalism. Maybe when you go in and demand a trade and you sit down with the GM, you say, hey, I've been doing everything I can to get us wins. We're not winning. Maybe it's something within your management team, or maybe we need new players. If you don't change things, I demand a trade. Now, hopefully, that's one option. Or you can simply go to the coach or the GM and say, hey, man, I've been doing everything I can. Things aren't looking up. I have a better opportunity in another city. Can I just request a trade? Maybe that's one thing. And the last thing to rescind the trade, what if, just what if, your ass, literally, you're behind at the game and the GM notices that you're not doing great at all. You don't have good team chemistry. You're not loyal. You're too cocky. Maybe the GM comes to you and say, hey, you're not what we thought you were. We thought that you were going to be better and you're not living up to your name. So with that being said, we want to trade you. And maybe you get down on your hands and knees and pray to the GM and say, please don't let me go. I would love to stay. I will show my worth. Maybe that's what you got to do to rescind the trade. So with that being said, in this screenshot, basically, Ronnie 2K was discussing the direction of the franchise in his second season. And in this particular screenshot, he was demanding a trade to another team. So with that being said, guys, this is IKC signing out. I'm hoping you guys like the screenshot. I'm hoping you like the details. Also, in my last video about the Kinect, there was actual gameplay from NBA 2K13. So you definitely want to go see that. But this is IKC signing out. You know where you want to get the NBA 2K13 info from, and that's me. Hit me up on Twitter at iPodKingCarter. I'll be there. Peace, y'all.